Alrighty, I'm trying something a little new. I'm swapping over my stuff to OBS Studio for a variety of reasons away from Streamlabs OBS. So if there's a bit of a scuff in the audio or some of my stream stuff might be scuffed, give me a couple days to get that figured out. But otherwise, let's get into it. There have been some recent changes on the 29th for the PTR for Warrior. Not as many changes as I would like, but anytime I see Warrior in the changes at all, makes me happy because I'm like, hey, ha, we're getting something, right? So here are the new changes. For the general class tree for Warrior, Second Wind gains an additional effect. While you're below 35% in health, restore 1% health every 1 second. The amount restored is increased the closer you are to death, max 2. That's actually pretty decent. Although, one of the problems with the current landscape of how damage is done to your character is essentially if your character's around 40% health, the next thing that hits you essentially kills you. There's not a lot of things in the game currently that basically deal this kind of rot damage that Second Wind would be really strong against, and this iteration would make you feel way safer against. It does mean Second Wind has a lot more applications now, considering it's not just, well, maybe you can use it during bursting week, because bursting is considered environmental damage, so it doesn't break the effect. And there's also some weird things on, like, Rashok, for example, has the you can use Second Wind on Rashok because a lot of the stuff doesn't get rid of the Second Wind effect, so it can keep you pretty healthy there. But realistically, it's kind of weird. It's kind of okay. There is also the note here of that they did change a few of the tier one talents, and they kind of shook them up a little bit in the base warrior class tree. So you can see this here. I haven't really done a bit of a dive into this, but it's very odd the way they change stuff around, where it's like you're basically still getting all of your required stuff, right? Like, I think, is Heroclip over here? I don't know, but Second Wind is now off of Impending Victory. I don't know. It's very odd. One of the things that is still a major, I would still say, considered an issue within the Warrior tree, and especially an issue for a Mountain Thane specifically, is the amount of required nodes. There's a lot of throughput nodes, and if you're playing Mountain Thane as an example, to get to Thunderclap, which is something you're going to want an AoE on arms, and something you're going to want with Mountain Thane, now you have to take Intervene or Stormbolt to get to Thunderclap, and I find that very, very weird. I feel like maybe they should change these two nodes here so you can maybe path through Pain and Gain. Because in a lot of PvE scenarios, disregarding Mythic Plus, you're not taking Stormbolt in raid. Like, what are you gonna do with this, right? Intervene has some incredibly niche applications, and even then, you're not really doing much with it, but I guess it's kind of forcing you to take like utility. But even then, why can't so if you put Stormbolt here instead of here and then move Pain and Gain up, it means you can path through Pain and Gain to get to all their PvE stuff. And then it also means that if you're pathing over here, you can still path to either Shockwave or Stormbolt based on your previous pathing, allowing you to choose what kind of CC you want without really impacting taking the things you want. One of the issues with the, we can't even call it a rework for Warrior, is that with this talent, these talent trees, we end up having to take a lot of things we don't actually potentially don't want or care for just to get to things that we need. Like, if we're playing Mountain Thane, well, you have to take that point. All right, well, then you're taking that point. Okay, then we need one point here for reinforced plates, and then, all right, well, we're taking this point. We gotta take this. I guess we're taking barbaric training because that works with the cleave talent. Okay, cool. 2 points in armor to the teeth. 2 points in this, mandatory, mandatory. 2 points here, mandatory. 7 of our points down here in our tree. This leaves us 4 points. We 7 of our remaining 11 points in the bottom part of this tree are essentially required. And now we also don't have the availability because of this inflexibility and just sheer gluttonous 2-point nodes that we have all throughout our tree. We can't even take anything like the stamina gain. But then one thing that also bothers me is we look at, oh, we can look at these talent calculators. What, like, we have armor node here, increased damage from armor node here, stamina node here. But then you look over at other trees and you go, well, what's going on with... Yeah, sorry. I don't know why it's doing that. You go, oh, what's going on with Red Paladin? And then you just see this fucking thing. Sanctified plates, stamina, armor, avoidance, and just a single node. So they have, like, a single node, which is a 2-point node, however, which does the same thing as, like, our 5-point node, like, 5 points of nodes. It's like, I mean, they don't necessarily get damage from the strength equal gain, but even then, that's a 2-point node that does the same thing as these nodes here and gives avoidance, so it's like a 3-point node, but it's in a 2. Like, what do we... I mean, this being a 1-point node, fine. This being a 2-point node, I just don't like how the entire bottom of our tree is gate-kept through pure throughput. Like, all 7 of these points are required for throughput, and then it's like, okay, well, do you want some stamina? No, you don't get stamina, because you got to take this. There you go. No stamina for you. And it's like, I don't like it. I really don't like the pathing in our tree. I think one thing that they've done that's been successful in a lot of other trees is simply just reducing the amount of 2-point nodes. Like, just reducing the amount of 2-point nodes. But there is a secondary, a potentially secondary cause for this, right? Because we look at all this and we see all these throughput and we see all these buttons. I mean, a lot of people really don't like Spear. But even then, the reality is, if we didn't have these 2-point nodes to choose from, we, like, if this was a 1-point node and this was a 1, like, if these were 1-point nodes, maybe, so you could get, like, you could get 2 points into this, if you wanted, instead, like, if this, it basically means if this is, like, a 1-point node, it means you can take Spear now. Like, it means at 1 point, 1 point, 1 point, and then you could, like, have Roar and Spear, and that's kind of degenerate, terrible garbage. So it's kind of saving us from ourselves with all of these 2-point nodes. But I think one of the issues is I think they need to move endurance training up somewhere in the tree. Like, endurance training should be up here somewhere, and then they should reduce these to maybe 1-point nodes, because just pure throughput, like, Having 4 points in the middle of our tree right here, that's just pure throughput that we need, it's just weird, man. The other trees don't have these problems. And I think that giving us, like, some of our stamina around here, maybe even putting the stamina, like, I don't know, putting, like, the Shattering Throw stuff potentially over here as, like, a 1-point node, maybe the stamina over here makes some of this a little more attractive. It just feels very weird. But this is also something that's a problem for, like I said, specifically Mountain Thane, where it's like, well, you need this, you need this, you need these two. I guess you have Stormbolt now. Honestly, maybe even they could change the spot of Shockwave and Stormbolt, so at least it's like, well, at least you're having, like, you have Shockwave instead of just Stormbolt, because Stormbolt by itself just kind of sucks. I don't know. I have a lot of issues with just the warrior class tree. Like, there's some weird scuff over here in our spec trees as well, but it feels very disheartening to have every other class, or most other classes, sorry, not every other class, get, like, an actual full, like, loving rework, and then we're sitting here with, like, a rearrangement, and it feels like they're throwing darts at a board trying to figure out, We're going to move Stormbolt. Yeah, we'll move it there. And it's like, what are we thinking here? What are we doing here? Because requiring CC and pathing, I mean, isn't like the worst idea, but at least give us the good ones, or at least like don't lock us into it this early. I mean, shit, put endurance training here. I don't know, man. Like I'm just not a fan of what's happening here, but I've talked about just the talent rearrangements a little. I mean, the talent rearrangements are major, right? So just talking about them kind of like gets me annoyed. But I think honestly, the biggest issues are going to be these two nodes. I think really should go to one pointers, and then it will allow us to actually have more flexibility for points in the middle of our tree. It literally just frees up two nodes, like two nodes that we can just kind of pick other stuff here. And this would especially help, like I said, Mount Thane, that requires these two nodes, or if you're playing AoE with arms and you're requiring these two nodes. This little section here needs some changing. I really think one of the things that they tried to do was fix the fact that they're like, hey, our pathing sucks. And they're like, oh, we'll move stuff around. But it's like, we don't want this. I mean, shit, put fucking leeching strikes over here and put Stormbolt over here. I don't know, man. But like, we essentially, what I think a success in this tree is going to be is if we can take all of this stuff that's raid focused, or take the stuff that's like, oh, you're gonna take leech, oh, you're gonna take the move speed, oh, you're gonna take leap, oh, you don't necessarily have to take pain and gain, but you can be like, oh, we're gonna take this, or this is throughput. If they can figure out how to smooth this stuff around to where all of the throughput nodes can make the tree itself, and then we have like two or three points that we can kind of put wherever if we want, like Intimidating Shout or Shockwave or Stormbolt, like just, or even like Bitter Immunity. If we can just have like two or three points in the middle of this tree that allow us to actually have some form of flexibility with picking things that we might want. I mean, shit, we might even want to put 2 points into Rumbling Earth if we're running this like Earthquaker talent, because it might be pretty good, right? So I think the primary culprit here is currently our pathing is still giving us things we don't necessarily want in a pure PvE setting, which I think can be remedied by changing stuff around. Even if it's not like, it's like, oh, the defensive and control aspect of the tree is here on the right side. I don't think anyone gives a fuck about that. I don't think anyone gives a shit about that. Just swap over leeching to the Stormbolt area, and then we can just put Stormbolt if we want to. If not, we can just straight path around it and path through all the PvE stuff we want. Because right now, it's not great. We don't have enough points. Very constrained for points, especially if you need to take something like Thunderclap, or they just need to make Thunderclap baseline, move this up here, move Leeching Strikes over here, Stormbolts over here. If you want Intimidating Shout, but don't worry, Stormbolt, you can still go through Impending Victory to get to Intimidating Shout. There's a lot of ways to fix this. But there's other patch notes we need to get to, right? But for Colossus specifically, they changed Bone Shaker, now increased the stun duration of Shockwave by 1 second, was 2, and slows the movement of all targets by 40% for 3 seconds. So it's kind of, this is more of a PvP change. It's this Brunbreaker talent here. This was Shockwave stun duration is increased by 2 seconds, which means Shockwave was going to be a AoE 4 second stun, which is very, very good. And they're like, let's tone it back, but we'll still add a little bit of CC on. Right, well, a little PvP on there. I'm like, yeah, okay, that's fine. They renamed Rally to Veteran Vitality, which they've kind of put the Rally effect into Second Wind, but it has its own secondary effect. Realistically, I honestly don't like Ignore Pain in the Arms tree. I just don't like it. I don't think it's a great button. I would rather it not be here. I just think Fueled by Violence should be way better, and they should just kind of shove some of what Ignore Pain is into Fueled by Violence by allowing Fueled by Violence to create a small overshield on your character instead of requiring ignore pain. But then for like the Mythic Plusers, I think having this ignore pain talent and then having ignore pain here is something you can take to guarantee bonus health or bonus shielding on certain things. That's fine, but that's just more of a personal thing. I just personally don't like ignore pain as a DPS warrior. I just don't like it. It's an okay tool, but I just personally don't care for it at all. Moving over to Slayer, however, they made some other changes. Relentless Pursuits removal, movement impairment effects can now only occur every 30 seconds. This effect will not trigger unless you are currently affected by movement impairing ability when you charge, and it gives a debuff that allows you to track it. This is more of a PvP change. Relentless Pursuit was here, but it's that charge removed all movement impairing effects, but it had no cooldown on it. So I'm assuming they did some testing, and then characters like Fury Warriors that have a PvP talent that allows them to get out of roots, and then your charge gives you out of roots, and then your second charge gets you out of roots, and then you have leap, and it was probably just a little too much, right? A little too much sticking for free with no real recourse. So that's why they probably moved that over and gave it a bit of a cooldown. Vicious Agility charge now reduces the cooldown heroic leap by 2 seconds, was 5. Vicious Agility is the other one, where when you leap, you reduce charge cooldown, and when you charge, you reduce leap cooldown. I don't really see a world where you're going to play around this, or why reducing the cooldown of leap was that big of a deal. I mean, maybe it's just a PvP change again, honestly, but this node is kind of whatever. I mean, Vicious Agility is decent. It gives you some decent a little extra mobility, but with stuff like Time Spiral in the game, especially in raid scenarios, like, you're just gonna have a charge of leap if you need it. So, I don't know. This note's kind of weird. It feels throwaway to me. It feels more like some PvP stuff, so I don't really care about it. Reap the Storm now has a 20% chance to trigger for Mortal Strike or Bloodthirst, was 2 RPPM on Overpower or Raging Blow. Reap the Storm. Oh, that's a spinny. Okay, so it's just, hey, 20% chance when you hit the thing, you do a spinny. They changed it from Overpower to Mortal Strike. Which is one thing that they've done, actually, especially with this upcoming change on Crushing Force, now increases Mortal Strike damage and Mortal Strike crit damage per point, and it was Slam instead before, is I feel like they're kind of trying to, while they're not reworking Warrior, it feels like they're trying to bring it almost like back to basics, where they're like, all right, guys, if you're in AoE, you're hitting fucking Cleave. If you're in single target or two target, you're hitting Mortal Strike. There is so many things that buff these buttons. We're going in here, like when we go to Colossus as an example, like Mortal Strike and Cleave damage increased by 20%. They're like, you're hitting these buttons. Mortal Strike buff, Cleave buff. Like this buff Cleave, this buff Cleave, or Fervor Battle now works with Cleave. Like, it feels like they're almost trying to bring Warrior back to basics, and then they're going to expand it out and like try and actually rework it, because we didn't get an actual rework. We just got these changes. So they're kind of just going, you hit the Mortal Strike or you hit the Cleave, or if you're sweeping strikes, maybe you still hit the Mortal Strike on like 2-3 targets, whatever. We'll figure out the math. But they changed Lethal Reflexes to Fierce Follow-Through, which is when you crit with Mortal Strike or Bloodthirst, it increases the next damage of your Mortal Strike or Bloodthirst. I mean, once again, it's just more damage on your primary button. Slayer's primary button for Fury is Bloodthirst, so it's like, hey, just hit your primary button more. All right. I mean, it's just trying to incentivize you to hit your primary buttons, right? So I'm fine with that. I forget what Lethal Reflexes was previously. Maybe I can find Lethal Reflexes Slayer. So, is it the same thing that they just renamed it? Because, I mean, Fierce Follow-Through sounds way better. I don't remember. Maybe it was, like, a cooldown or something. Who cares? But now, with the Arms Tree, Crushing Force now increases Mortal Strike damage and crit damage. So it's like, hey, man, hit the Mortal Strike button. You have 20% more damage here. 10% more damage here. And crit damage here. You have crit damage amp here. You have crit damage amp here. You have Martial Prowess buffing your Mortal Strikes with more crit damage. You have Overpower when it resets Mortal Strike generates Rage, allowing you to actually have a little bit of Rage economy. They also removed the Overpower damage from Battle Lord, which, because that was it made Battle Lord really bloated. But one of the biggest problems that have been kind of plaguing Warrior, at least this expansion, is how crazy Overpower was. Overpower and Dreadnought were just way too good, and they even buffed them again previously in like season 3, and then I think they realized, why the fuck is this filler spell doing more damage than all of your primary abilities in a dungeon? Like, my number 1 and 2 were like Overpower Dreadnought, or it was like Dreadnought Overpower, because of just how much they did. And they probably looked at that, and they looked at all of these different amps that Overpower was getting, and they finally realized, hey, maybe hitting the buttons you actually should be pressing should do the damage, not your filler spell, right? Like, your filler spell is supposed to be a filler. It stacks up for Overpower, stacks up for Cleave, makes your Mortal Strike better, makes your Cleave better, make you want to hit the two good button, Cleave AoE, Mortal Strike. But now it's this, but that's why they've kind of basically been neutering Overpower and Dreadnought, because they kind of needed to. It was just too much. Like, the button was just too much. And this is where you see no longer increases Overpower damage. This increased Overpower damage by 35%, which also translated to Dreadnought damage. So this is actually a very large nerf to Overpower in general. But with the change to the Rage economy, the generates 10 Rage is probably still going to be good enough, on top of the fact that anytime you're resetting with like Exhilarating Blows or resetting with Battle Lord, it means you're just going to be Mortal Striking a lot, which makes Demolish resets happen more. If you're Mortal Striking a lot, it makes the Blade Storms happen more for Slayer. So they're just really trying to kind of hone in on this kind of gameplay, where we're kind of going back to like Mortal Strike and Overpower, Mortal Strikes and Cleaves, instead of, well, at this target cap, you need to Sweeping Strikes with Battle Lord, with Dreadnought at this target cap, or you can Whirlwind with Sword of Storms. They're just trying to simplify it, is what they're doing. And I think they're in the right direction, but they need to fix the class tree a bit more for that. Seismic Reverberation now also triggers from Cleave. So now, hey, guess what? Seismic Reverberation, more Cleave. Hey, you hit Cleave. Cleave do the damage. Do more damage. Ah, Cleave good button AoE. Hee. See, they just want you to hit the two buttons. And they even change Barbaric Training to also work with Cleave. All right. It's kind of weird, because I don't actually know. I mean, I guess Sidearm is going to be the single target button you take now. But it kind of, because even if you're buffing Slam, the problem is you're probably going to be, with the amount of Mortal Strikes you want to cast, you're probably going to be running Exhilarating Blows and Battle Lord, right? So I don't even know how much value you're going to be getting out of Slam in single target scenarios, especially with the nerf to Slam and the buff to Mortal Strike again. So maybe Sidearm's going to be the single target option, even though it hits multiple enemies. We'll just see how the math pans out, right? Maybe the math is good. Maybe the math is bad. Maybe you're still taking barbaric training. I don't know. We'll just see what the robot says. But yeah, overall, I think they're working in the right direction. This class tree just has some major pathing issues and some major placement issues, and it really just needs a little more work. I really think that it has some very significant just talent point problems. There I do have something for you guys coming on Monday. I'm not going to tell you what it is. I want to keep it a surprise, but we're going to do another, basically another State of Warrior, like I did with Zan and Gajeel. But I have some super sick dudes to talk to, and I really hope you enjoy that. And that's going to be Monday at 4 p.m. Eastern Standard Time, 10 p.m. European Time, or Central European Time, I think. If you are interested in that, it's going to be some very good warrior talk. It's something I've been trying to set up for weeks, so I'm very excited for it. But these are our current alpha changes. Hopefully we see some more. The beta is coming out pretty soon. I've been waiting to try and get into the alpha so I can actually test things myself and actually touch the classes. But I do have the Epic Edition already because of I bought it through buying WoW tokens through doing mount sales. So we'll have that. I'll actually be able to be boots on the ground and test stuff, try it out. And I'm really looking forward to that on the 5th. But otherwise, I rambled a lot. If there is audio issues or there's video issues and artifacting, please let me know. I am going to be working on making sure my OBS is set up correctly, everything sounds fine, and I hope the quality is a little better for you guys. Thank you very much for watching, and I hope you have a good one. Bye-bye.